Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2208, VLOOKUP to two tables. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question from Flo in Nashville. Now, Flo has to do a bunch of VLOOKUPs, but here's the deal. Each of these part numbers is either found in Catalog 1, the Frontlist catalog, or it's found in Catalog 2. So, Flo wants to first look in Frontlist, and if it's found, beautiful, just stop. But if it's not, then move on and check the backlist. All right, this is going to be easier thanks to a new function that came along in Excel 2010 called IFERROR. All right, so we're going to do a regular VLOOKUP here into the front list, comma, two, comma, false. By the way, that is a named range there. I created a name range for front list and one for backlist, right? So front list, just choose that whole name, click in there, front list, one word, no space. Same thing here, choose the whole second catalog, type in the, click in the name box, type backlist, press enter, no space. All right, so you see that some of these work and some of them don't. All right, so for the ones that don't, we're going to use a function that came along in Excel 2010 called IFERROR. IFERROR is pretty cool. It lets the first VLOOKUP happen, and if the first VLOOKUP works, it just stops. But if the first VLOOKUP returns an error, either an NA, like in this case, or a division by zero, or anything like that, then we're going to move on to the second piece, the value of error. And while most of the time I put something in there like not found, this time I'm actually going to go do another VLOOKUP. So lookup A4 into the backlist catalog, comma, two, comma, false. All right, and so that closes the value of error, and then another parenthesis, that one in black, to close the original if error. Press Control Enter, and what we get is all of the answers either from table one, the front list catalog, or from table two, the backlist catalog. Cool, cool trick. Great idea from Flo. Never thought about doing that, but it makes a lot of sense if you have two catalogs. And I suppose you could even wrap, if there was a third catalog, right? You could even wrap this VLOOKUP in an if error and then have yet another VLOOKUP. And it'll just keep chaining right down the list. Going to catalog one, catalog two, catalog three. Beautiful, beautiful trick. All right, now, VLOOKUP covered in my book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 greatest Excel tips of all time. Click that eye in the top right-hand corner for more information. Okay, wrap up from this episode. Flo from Nashville, can I VLOOKUP into two different tables? Look for the item in Catalog 1. If it's found, then great. But if it's not, then move on and do a VLOOKUP in Catalog 2. So my solution, start with the VLOOKUP that looks up the first catalog, but then wrap that VLOOKUP in the IFERROR function. That was new in Excel 2010. If you have Excel 2013, you can even use the IFNA function, which will do pretty much the same thing. And the second piece of that is what to do if it's false. Well, if it's false, then go do the VLOOKUP into the backlist catalog. Cool idea from Flo. Great question from Flo. And I wanted to pass that along. Now, hey, to download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL down there in the YouTube description. I want to thank Flo for showing up in my seminar in Nashville. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.